What is going on, everybody? As you can see, we today are gonna be a cowboy, an outlaw, if you will, of the old west. We're gonna be doing some Red Dead Redemption 2. I thoroughly enjoyed this game when I played it when it came out and all that, so I figured might as well. We finished up Star Wars Fallen Order, or Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order, and this is a great fucking game. I love this one. Mi padre loved it too. We play it. We play through the story together at the same time. Like I went through and beat the story, and then came back, and every now and then I'd go out there and sit in the living room with him while he played it and all that. It was fun. But we're going to be a cowboy. By 1899, the age of outlaws and gunslingers was at an end. America was becoming a land of laws. Even the West had mostly been tamed. A few gangs still roamed, but they were being hunted down and destroyed. Rockstar Games presents. Red Dead Redemption 2.
Abigail says he's dying, Dutch. We'll have to stop someplace.
Okay. Arthur's out looking. I sent him up ahead.
If we don't stop soon, we'll all be dying. This weather, it's May. I'm just hoping the law got as lost as we did.
There. Arthur! Any luck?
I found a place where we can get some shelter. Let Davy rest while he, you know. An old mining town. Abandoned. It ain't far. Come on.
Come on! Yeah!
Chapter 1, Coulter. Now, right off the bat, I think I'm going to try to find my favorite sidearm.
Bring him in here!
Quick as I can, anyways. Make sure to get it as soon as physically possible. You may be wondering what my favorite sidearm is of the Old West. And, I mean, it's not a performance, you know,
Miss Gaskell,
guru or anything like that.
Quick.
But,
Miss Jones, bring in whatever blankets we have. Mr. Pearson, see what we've got in terms of food.
Camp manager.
Davy's dead.
There was nothing more you could have done.
What are we gonna do? We need supplies.
Well, first of all, you're gonna stay here. And you were going to get yourself warm. Now, I sent John and Mike scouting out ahead. Arthur and I, we're going to ride out. See if we can find one of them.
Miss?
Just for a short bit. I don't see what other choice we have. Listen. Listen to me, all of you, for a moment. Now, we've had, a bad couple of days. I loved Davey, Jenny, Sean, Mac. They may be okay. We don't know. But we lost some folks. Now, if I could throw myself in the ground, in their stead, I'd do it, gladly. But we're gonna ride out, and we're gonna find some food. Everybody, we're safe now. There ain't nobody following us through a storm like this one. And by the time they get here, well, we're gonna be long gone. We've been through worse than this before. Mr. Pearson, Miss Grimshaw, I need you to turn this place into a camp. We may be here for a few days. Now, all of you, get yourselves warm. Stay strong. Stay with me. We ain't done yet. Come on, Arthur.
All right. We've got some work to do.
We ain't run into them yet, so they both must have headed down the hill.
Sure. Hey, I ain't had time to ask. What really went down back there on that boat?
We missed you. That's what happened. Come on.
Oh. You may be.
Hey, you need horses?
Oh, yeah. Hey, Mr. Smith. Get yourself indoors. You need to rest that hand.
I'll live.
Get indoors, son.
Bye. All right, here we go.
Need you strong.
Okay.
But you may be wondering what kind of sidearm is my favorite.
Ain't sure what we're gonna find out here, Dutch.
That would be the Schofield revolver. I like the break action. It's a nifty design to me.
This goddamn weather.
Been 2 days or more like this now. Oh, it has to blow over soon. Bridge coming up. Take it easy.
Can't believe we lost Davey, too.
He's the last one, Arthur. No more. We need to get those people warm and fed.
At least we don't need to worry about Pinkerton's tailing us in this.
A couple more days, we'll be on the other side.
Oh, shit.
Doing?
Hit the wrong button, that's all. Come on, game, let me mount my horse.
Others back up. You're the only one I can rely on to stay strong right now. Hey, I think I see something up the path. You up ahead. Who's there? Micah.
Gentlemen.
Found anything?
I think so. Found a little homestead down that way.
Okay. Anyone home?
Sure. The place is blazing with light and noise. Sounded like a party.
Let's go see.
Follow me. How's Davey doing?
He didn't make it. Nor did little Jenny.
That's too bad. Davey was a real fighter. Both of them calendar boys is. Or was.
Yeah.
And Mac, Sean?
We don't know.
Quite a business.
I'm glad you're all right, Micah.
Always.
Ask him if he's seen John.
Hey, have you seen John, Micah?
Didn't see much of anything once this storm came in.
He hasn't seen him.
He'll be fine. Things always turn out right for that boy.
are still out there somewhere, too. Move up, Arthur. I'll cover the rear.
Yep.
You run into anybody else?
I reckon we're the only ones crazy enough to be out in this, Morgan.
Yeah, well, don't talk to me about Creighton.
Oh, so no, glad you're all right. I was worried, Micah. Look, it's all gonna work out.
Okay, let's keep it down now, gentlemen. It's just up ahead.
Okay, let's head down there.
Displayed in the lower corner.
Let's hitch up here.
Whoa. I really gotta mount up perfectly. Or hitch up perfectly. Only to hitch.
Let me do the talking. We don't want to scare these folks.
Dutch. Sounds like quite the party.
You two, get yourself out of sight. One lonely man is a lot less intimidating than three nasty-looking degenerates. Micah, hide behind that wagon. Arthur, you take that old shed on the left and stay low, both of them. Excuse me! Hello! Oh, well, hello, friend.
What you want?
I am very sorry to disturb you. My friends and I, well, we got into some trouble up the way, lost in the storm. Ah, gentlemen.
We can't help you, mister.
I got folks.
Arthur.
Dying on the
trail. Arthur, we got a problem. There's a corpse right here.
Now I just
Arthur, there's a body in the wagon.
I hear you. Just
gentlemen,
keep your eyes on Dutch.
Please.
I think you go now, but
now, friend, I ain't asking. Search the cabin.
Smells like a party in here.
Turn the place upside down. Grab as many supplies as you can. We need the essentials. Food, medicine, whiskey.
I'm starving.
Well, you should eat something now. Get your strength up for the ride back.
It's a strange one, all right. Maybe they're hiding up here, too. There's a big price on Colm O'Driscoll's head. Nearly as big as the one on yours.
Wanting Colm dead is about the only thing me and Uncle Sam agree on.
Big old pool of blood on the floor here.
I saw.
Probably the poor bastard who lived here. Micah found a dead body in the wagon outside. This place is dry and warm. We could maybe move the women and Jack down here.
Maybe. We'll see how they are when we get back. I don't really want us to split up. I'm going to start packing the horses. You keep looking. Meet me out here when you're done.
Confused on how that fella got up there.
Hmm. Poor bastard was married too.
Jake and Sadie's wedding, September 4th, 1896. Need to inspect something. Okay. All right, so let's get the hell out of here.
Micah, Arthur, keep looking for stuff. Arthur, go see if there's anything in that barn. Micah, you search the cabin, see what we missed.
Sure. Will talk. Where's Como, Driscoll?
With the others. At an old mining camp southwest of here, near the lake.
What are you bastards doing? Why are you up here?
We're fixing to rob some train. Gonna blow the tracks. I don't know more than that, I swear.
Well, I would say it looks like you have this, Arthur. Do what you want with him. I don't care. But bring that horse when you're done.
Oh. I don't know anything else.
Get the hell out of here. Go. Anyway,
that looks like a decent horse. You should keep him. Tie him up over there, Arthur.
Get away from me!
pistols.
No, she ain't, Michael. Look at her. Miss, miss. Yes. Are you...
Oh, you fool, Michael.
Miss, now, it is going to be okay. We mean you no harm. Miss, miss. Come on. It'll be okay. We need to get out of here, and quick. Come on. Oh. You okay, miss?
They came 3 days ago. And my husband, they...
Okay. Miss, you are safe now. And you can't stay here.
Definitely can't.
You come with us. Arthur.
Miss, it's okay. We're bad men. We ain't them. So, it's okay. Get on. We'll keep you safe until you figure out what you want to do.
What's your name, miss? Miss.
Sadie, I think.
Adler.
Adler.
Sadie Adler.
Oh, okay.
Mrs. He was my husband.
Hey, somebody's coming. Looks like it's Dutch. Hey, everybody, Dutch is back.
How'd you get on?
Micah found a homestead, but he weren't the first. Colm O'Driscoll and his scum, they beat us to it. We found some of them there, but there is more about, apparently. Scouting the train. Thank you.
That's the last thing we need right now, Dutch.
Well, it is what it is. But we found some supplies, some blankets, a little bit of food, and this poor soul, Mrs. Adler. Miss Tilly, Miss Karen, would you warm her up? Give her a drink or something?
And Mrs. Adler, it's gonna be okay. You're safe now. They turned her into a widow. Animals. I need some rest. I haven't slept in 3 days.
You're over here. Miss O'Shea will show you the way. Mr. Morgan, we put you in a room over here.
Thank you, Miss Grimshaw.
Mr. Bell, you're with the fellas over there.
What? How come Arthur gets a room and I get a bunk bed next to Bill Williamson and a bunch of darkies?
Get yourself to bed.
Whew. That'll tighten everything up.
Days. Weather ain't let up.
He's strong. And he's smart.
Strong, at least. Hello, Arthur.
Abigail.
Arthur, how you doing?
Just fine, Abigail. And you?
I need you to... I'm sorry to ask, but...
It's little John. He's got himself caught into a scrape again.
He ain't been seen in two days.
Your John will be fine. I mean, he may be as dumb as rocks and as dull as rusted iron, but that ain't changing because he got caught in some snowstorm.
Please go take a look. Javier?
Yes.
Javier, will you ride out with Arthur to take a look for John? You're the two best fit men we've got.
Now?
We're pretty worried about him.
I know. The situation were reversed, and he'd look for me.
Thank you.
This way.
Javier has a fair point.
I know, John was headed up the river.
For all we know, he kept riding north and never looked back.
He wouldn't leave. Not like that.
Wouldn't be the first time.
Thank you. Such a beautiful game.
Hey, I see some smoke. Come on, let's take a look.
Let's hope it ain't more of O'Driscoll's boys.
Well, seems somebody left. Recently. And that way.
Sure, well, come on then.
There's some tracks leading to the river.
A few hours ago, most.
Let's cross. See, they continue up that way.
You think it's John?
You tell me. These are horse tracks for sure, but could be anyone. Let's just see where they lead.
So?
Brightness might be a little high up. Hold on. Settings. Display. No, not colorblind mode. It might be in general, then. Graphics, maybe. So it'll be in general. Or not. Camera? Really? What's field of view? I do want the field of view up. Did I just miss it? That's quality. Preset level, custom. There. It ain't here. All right, let's head back, I guess.
You were there, Javier. What really happened on that boat?
We had the money, it seemed fine. And suddenly they were everywhere.
Bounty hunters?
No, Pinkerton. It was crazy. Raining bullets. Take it slow. Big ravine here. Dutch killed a girl in a bad way. But it's a bad situation.
That ain't like him, though.
We continue along the cliff wall here. Davey got shot. Mac and John, both shot too. Sean, we don't even know. I'm surprised we escaped at all. By the time you boys showed up from the other side of town, we were only just holding on.
Bad business, all right. Damn snow's coming in hot again.
We'll lose these tracks if we don't move fast. Watch yourself, it's not very wide here.
I do. Dead horse.
John was riding that horse when we left Blackwater. Let's see if he can hear us.
I hear something.
Come on. Up there.
Come on. Come on.
coming from up ahead somewhere. I don't think we can go much further on the horses. We have to walk from here. I'd grab that shotgun from your horse. Who knows what's up ahead?
I don't like the fact that I gotta ditch my pistol.
Down this way.
Fucking Javier is just walking like it's nothing.
You sure about this?
Coming from this way.
Okay.
Watch out here. Mierda, that we're high up here.
You're telling me.
Help me.
Drops down here. Watch out. Watch out. Careful. Low under here. Okay, good now.
Watch your step. This is real slippery.
Stay close to the wall. Up here. Come on. Come on.
Over here.
That sounds closer now. Come on. We're coming, John!
Damn, it's cold.
Come on. Arthur, pick up the damn pace. Ain't no time like the present.
Let's keep moving then. Come on. John!
John, you there? John!
I'm here! Down on the ledge!
That's John! We're coming!
Hey! Down here!
All right! Hot down, Marston! That's quite a scratch you got there.
Never thought I'd say this, but it's good to see you, Arthur Morgan.
You don't look so good.
I don't feel too good, neither. I'm freezing.
Don't die just yet, cowboy.
On, compadre.
1, 2, 3. Yep.
Well, we can't go back the way we came. Let's try this way.
Ain't you a sorry sight?
Can't argue with you there.
See? I told Dutch you weren't the right man for this.
I'm sure you did.
You all right?
I don't think so.
Come on. Hopefully this will lead us out. Look up there.
Shit. I'll distract him while you get to the horses. Go. Draw them off.
Hey, John, come on. Let's get you on that horse. Okay, let's get going before any more of these bastards show up.
a stab at them. Wish I could cut them up. It'd be some pretty good meat. Tennessee Walker, that one must be mine. Oh, that one that was out here?
Just like a dog bite.
You knew a fella? Got bit by a dog. Died an hour later.
You ain't gonna die. Not yet. Up there? Four of them!
That's
get out of here! Get up! Shit, there's more on the right! We got more wolves on the left! Get out of here! Get out of here! Lárgate de aquí! You see any more, Arthur?
Don't think so.
Jesus!
You still with us, Marston?
Just about.
You're gonna be okay. We have some shelter now.
Thanks for coming for me.
Of course. That bullet in Blackwell. Now this. You had a hell of a time.
And Arthur always says, I'm lucky.
Should ride in the water for a bit. Try to lose a scent. Don't want to leave a trail right back to camp.
You know, we're gonna need to come up with a better story for that scar.
So, freezing, bleeding, starving, damn near getting eaten to death ain't good enough for you.
Here, let's cross to the left.
Yeah, come on. Let's push hard and get back.
See those buildings up ahead, John? That's where we camped. Nearly there.
Some help! We need some help here!
Come on, help him down.
You're alive! You're alive!
Here we go. There we go. Ay, careful, idiotas! It's his leg!
Oh, come on, let's get you warm. Thank you. Thank you both. This is a new low, even by your standards.
Thank you, Arthur. Thank
you. You got any other lost maidens need saving?
Not today.
Have you and Dutch talked about how we're gonna get out of this?
I was just discussing with Herr Strauss when the weather breaks. I suppose we'll have to keep heading east.
East? Into all that civilization?
I know. The west is where our problems are worse. Come on, Herr Strauss. Let's get warm.
Thank you, Mr. Muggy.
Oh, Mr. Morgan.
Just a scratch.
We have been running for weeks. We found shelter and been resting here in some old abandoned mining town while we wait the thaw. Hardly the spring I had been hoping for.
I agree with that one.
So what now, Dutch?
We get strong, we get warm, and we wait. When the storm breaks, we move. Sound doubtful.
Not doubtful, just worried.
We have been shot at before, Jose. I don't feel that this is honestly anything new.
I hope not.
We had a bit of bad luck. But then the storm covered our tracks, so now we wait a bit, and we go back to Blackwater, and we get our money, or we get some more money, and we keep heading west.
But we're heading east.
For now. For now. We got this. We're safe. Stay strong, Hosea. What about you, Arthur? You doubt me too?
Never.
Good. Because you know me, son. I'm just getting started. Once we get some money, well, they better send some good men after us, because they ain't never gonna find us. But we need money.
Of course, Dutch.
Thank you, son, for your strength. It means a lot to me.
And the money's well hidden in Blackwater?
I believe so. And they don't even know we dumped it.
Well, you can wait then. We weren't there, Hosea.
I'm aware of that. And they shouldn't have been either.
Oh, we can't change nothing now.
Had a bent into the camp. Woo.
We're gonna starve to death up here, Mr. Morgan.
We're okay.
We have a few cans of food and a rabbit. For what, 10, 12 people? When I was in the Navy.
I do not wish to hear about what you got up to in the Navy, Mr. Pearson.
We were stranded at sea for 50 days.
And you unfortunately survived.
When we ran away from Blackwater, I wasn't able to get supplies in.
Well, when government agents are hunting you down, sometimes shopping trips need to be cut short. We'll survive. We always have.
If needs be, we can eat you. You're the fattest.
I sent Lenny and Bill hunting, and they found nothing.
Well, Lenny's more into book learning than hunting. Bill's a fool. Unless those mountains are full of game that want to read, ain't no wonder they found
enough of this. We'll go find something. Come on, Arthur. Wait a second. Hold on. Here. You're gonna need something to eat out there.
Assorted, salted offal. Starving would be preferable.
Come on, let's go.
You can't go hunting. Look at your hand.
I can't stay here listening to you two. Look, if there's game in those hills, I'll find it. And you can kill it.
You need to rest, Charles.
You think this is rest? Come along.
I'll give it to you, Charles. You're confident.
Here, you take this. I can't use it, and you'll have to.
Oh, you're joking.
Use a gun, and we'll scare off every animal for miles around. You're never too old to learn, I imagine.
All right, let's head out. How are you holding up, Charles?
I'm okay, apart from this hand. Stupid mistake.
Still bad?
It'll be fine in a day or two. I just can't pull a bow right now.
I sure hope I can. Never really got the hang of it.
You'll be fine.
So, you reckon we're gonna find something to kill that ain't no Driscoll?
There's meat up here for sure. Pearson doesn't know what he's talking about. Now the weather's eased off a bit, they'll be needing to feed. We'll head up this way, find some higher ground.
Been a wild few days, all right. And riding north from Blackwater, getting stuck in the storm, bringing John back in.
You've had a lot put on you. I wish I could have done more.
I didn't mean it like that, just a lot to think back on.
I still don't really know what happened on that boat.
Me neither. Well, Javier told me a bit, but it sure weren't good.
Look down this way. The wind's died down too.
That's good.
No wind at all is bad, but if it's too strong, they won't move. Now shh. Stay quiet.
Yeah. Whoa.
Hey, stop here a second. I see something.
Tracks.
There's deer been here recently.
How can you tell?
How can you not? We'll track them on foot. You're gonna need the bow. Don't leave it on your horse. Quietly and slowly. You see the tracks?
I think so. Maybe not.
Focus.
Yeah, I got them.
Look, there they are. Are you ready with that bow? Try to hit them in the neck or head, quick and clean. Keep good tension on the string before releasing. Just don't overdo it. Now, Arthur, that's okay. Try again.
Fuck.
Watch yourself, Arthur, or we'll scare them all off.
Fuck. Is that all I have that helps? Come on now.
Following the tracks, Arthur.
Got it.
Well done. I think that's all we can carry.
Okay, you pick up one, I'll get the other.
You sure your hand's okay?
It'll be fine once I get it on my shoulder.
Okay, I'll go grab the other one.
Horse! I'm heading Charles' way.
Ready to head back when you are.
Sure. I just need to finish up here. Come on, then. Let's head back.
All right. Following you.
Should be enough.
Oh, can't you control that thing?
Should be enough meat here to keep us all fed for a few days.
You found him.
I knew you'd be okay with that bow.
Yeah, it's easier when they ain't shooting back.
We've seen enough of that.
Considering how things were looking a couple of days back, well, maybe our luck is finally on the turn.
Seems to me we should be putting our effort into getting off this mountain now.
Soon. People are still weak, and well, you've seen how snowed in those wagons are.
They ain't going nowhere until we get some more thaw.
You're probably right. And even if we do get off here, what then? Still have a big price on our heads.
This is a big country. We'll find somewhere to lie low. Dutch and Jose will have a plan. You notice how Pearson's had a bottle in his hand ever since we fled Blackwater? We give the camp cook 5 minutes to grab the essentials and go, and he doesn't even bring a crumb of food.
Good that we caught more than one. A lot of mouths to feed.
And that girl from the ranch now, too. Well, not sure she'll be eating much.
She has a wild look in her eye.
You would, too. She lost her husband, her home, everything she had.
So what do we do with her?
Once we get out of here and we're back on our feet, we'll see. She might have family somewhere.
So it was O'Driscoll's you ran into there?
Yeah. Last thing we was expecting.
What is it with the O'Driscoll's?
You ain't dealt with them? I suppose. Yeah, we ain't run into them much the last 6 months. I guess because they've been over this way.
Yeah. I've heard a lot of talk about them.
Well, we've been scrapping over scores with them for years. Big gang. Nasty sons of bitches. Their leader, Combe, and Dutch go way back. And not in a good way. A proper blood feud.
So I heard.
Easy!
Careful.
Watch out. Bear up ahead. Let's see if we can find another way around.
Boy.
He must be real hungry. Stay well back. Spring storms like this are the worst for animals that sleep all winter.
Yeah.
Good boy. Cut up here, off the trail.
Now? 5-6 months?
Something like that.
But you didn't expect this.
What?
Any of this. Blackwater mess. Being up here.
Sooner or later, a job's gonna go wrong. Nature of life.
I just thought you might have moved on by now.
You want me to move on?
No. No, not at all. I know you could run it alone, no problem.
I did that for a long time. I'm done with it. Always wondering if someone's gonna kill you in your sleep.
I still wonder that most nights.
I reckon you're okay. This suits me. Sure, I could fall in with another gang, but Dutch. You know, Dutch is different.
Oh, yes. Dutch is certainly different.
He treats me fair. Most of you do. And for a fellow with a black father and an Indian mother, that ain't normally the case.
Well, we need you now. More than ever.
Good. And how long have you been with these boys? Why ain't you run off?
Me? Oh, 20 years, something like that. Since I was a boy.
20 years?
Yeah. Taught me to read. John, too. Tell me a few other things, him and Hosea.
Huh. I'm sure.
Dutch saved me. Saved most of us. That's why we need to stick by him through this. He always sees us right.
How's that new horse,
Arthur?
He's all right. He'll do for now. I appreciate you letting me take Taima the other night.
She's a strong one. It's been as hard on the horses as on the rest of us. I don't know what Dutch would do if something happened to the Count.
Same with Bill and Brown Jack. He's a drunk, miserable bastard, but
He loves that horse.
I hope they all make it.
I tried to ride the count once. Bucked me faster than a bull. Won't take nobody but him.
I'm gonna hitch-tie him over here.
Brought some food back, boys! Come on, let's get these over to Pearson.
And thank you for showing me how to use the bow properly.
I only showed you a little. It takes a lifetime of practice to master.
Just drop it down in here.
What a surprise. Find a camp rat loitering around in the kitchen.
Is that any way to greet an old friend? I feel like we haven't spoken for days.
I do my utmost to avoid you.
Why, he loves me, really. It's his sad way of showing affection.
No, it isn't. Now shoot, get lost.
Well, see you gents later.
See, you got on just fine.
Charles is a wonder.
Have a drink, boys. You earned it.
Jesus, what is that?
Navy rum, sir. It's the only thing. The only thing. Keeps you sane, it does.
Yeah, oh. Seems to have done a treat on you. You go rest that hand, Charles.
I'll be fine in a few days.
You mind helping me with the skinning, Mr. Morgan? It's easier if we do it together.
You'll get to skin you.
You're always one with the jokes, aren't you? Come on.
This really isn't a job for a man with a burnt hand. I'll see you both later.
You skin that one that you dumped on the floor there.
You told me to put it anywhere.
Huh. Not too bad, Mr. Morgan. Yeah. They always said you were a butcher. You know, you could trade these or sell these in pretty much any town. If you're looking to make a legitimate bit of money, of course.
Right now, I'm just looking to get off this mountain alive.
Well, if you catch anything else, you bring it to me.
Sure.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Heck, Arthur Morgan's first decent bit of hunting after all these years.
Yeah. Well, we're on the run now. Everyone's got to do their bit to survive. Just make a good stew. Folk need it. It's been a tough few days.
Yes, it has. I guess I can see what's going on. You stay there for right a second.
Stay alert there, Javier.
Hello. Up with you boys, because I thought you liked action. Couple of days on the lam, you lot have all turned yellow. Apart from you, of course.
Shut up, Micah.
I ain't never seen so many long faces. I guess folks miss them. I fell, but when I fall, I don't want no fuss.
When you fall, there'll be a party.
A party? Probably. Uh-huh. Funny, huh? Sure. I don't feel like being laughed at by the likes of you two.
Stop it! Now! You fools punching each other when Como Driscoll's needing punching hard. You want to sit around waiting for him to come find us? All of you, we got work to do. Come on.
Are you sure about this, Dutch?
Yes.
We've been through a lot recently. We hardly back on our feet yet.
And the last thing we need is to get bushwhacked by Como Driscoll. Let's go.
I know you hate him, Dutch.
He's here for us.
I doubt that.
No, you're just doubting me.
I would never doubt you, Dutch. You always said revenge is a luxury we can't afford.
This is the right call, Arthur. Take this. And this is about more than revenge for business long ago. They were talking about trains and detonators here. Cole always had good information. Come on.
And you think now is the right time to hit a train?
Now, you might fancy living on deer piss and rabbit shit. I'm getting too old for that life. Mr. Matthews, Mr. Smith, Mr. Pearson, would you please look after the place? There are O'Driscolls about. Yeah! Southwest, right, Arthur?
Yeah. He said follow the main trail southwest. They're camped near some lake.
Okay, let's go find these bastards before they find us and rob this core of their planet.
Okay then, horse.
What's that? Tracks. Horses, quite a few of them. As far as I can tell, the only fools out here are us and them. They must be this way.
You good, Dutch?
Of course. Listen. I know you don't think much of my ideas recently, but idiot!
Wow.
But this is the right move.
Okay. You know I got your back.
I learned a long time ago that you hit Colm O'Driscoll. Wait for him, and people you love will die.
This feud between you and him needs to be put to rest, one way or another.
It will be.
Some things I can forgive, others I can't forget. What he did to Hannibal, I can't do neither.
You killed his brother, Dutch.
Yes, I did. And I hope the bastards will be reunited soon enough. That's how this'll end. See that smoke? Let's cut up here and take a look. They said it was near the lake, so we must be close. Gentlemen, this is it. Are we goddamn ready?
Ready, Dutch.
Good. Now, Mr. Morgan and I, we're gonna head up here a little, see if we can't get a sense of the layout of the camp. Mr. Williamson, Mr. Bell, you two take up a hidden position just outside the camp. Mr. Summers, Mr. Escuela, you two hold position here. Let's go.
Can I get my weapons off? Apparently not.
There they are. That's definitely them.
Home?
I think so.
Yeah, that's him.
Who's he talking to? He don't seem very happy.
No.
Definitely not.
They leaving?
Seem to be. Should we go get them?
No. Colm can wait. Best to get some of them out of there. And much less fun to rob him and his score if he never finds out about it. Come on, let's get down there. Forget to grab that rifle from your horse. You two, get up there and keep us covered.
You got it, Dutch.
wish I could swap these two right in a second.
It's easiest to take the same path down as Bill and Micah. Like you said, revenge is a luxury we can't afford.
Yeah, just wasn't sure you agreed with me.
Arthur, have you completely lost faith in me? Our needs right now are supplies, equipment, and a way out of here. Everything else, including Colm, can wait.
Okay.
There's enough of those bastards down there to deal with as it is. Now come on. Watch out. It's a bit steep.
Maybe I should take the lead on this. They're going to be gunning for you.
They ain't got me yet.
No, but the way our luck's been running.
Hush. Let's just get down there first. Down through these trees, quick. Come on, follow me. Get in cover, Arthur.
That fella smacked you up something.
So, what are we doing, Doug? I can take this if you want.
Just make the call. You want to take the lead? Go.
I'll go first.
So why'd they let you go? I wouldn't have done. Fella didn't have much choice, was picking his teeth off the floor. And you didn't tell him nothing. Not a word.
O'Driscoll! You're dead, you shut!
My damn hat, hold on.
Thank you.
Search the bodies. Strip everything we can from them.
Fucking advance. These bastards for sure. Nothing else, I'm gonna get plenty of ammo off of them. I already did, damn. $1.85 that guy had on.
We're waiting on you, Arthur.
You You may be waiting on me, but I'm gonna loot this fucking place for sure.
Arthur, get over here.
Give me a damn second. How you want?
Good work, boys. Now, let's tear this place apart. Bill, you go search that wagon there. Mike, search that building. Arthur, you take that building to the left. All right, man, quick! Find those detonators, explosives, anything you can. Let's go!
Here. This looks good. What do you think, Bill?
Looks fine. Smells good.
Come on.
Did we get everything?
Think so, boss. Found this on one of them.
Thank you.
This is perfect.
Oh, yeah. Interesting. This is something about the train they was gonna rob. A Mr. Leviticus Cornwall. Mount back up. Let's keep moving.
Oh.
All right. Let's get out of here. Proud of you boys. All of you. Not a man down.
I just want to loot these last three bodies. Give me a damn second. Alright.
Back to what you were saying.
Good work, fellas.
Not bad for some starving down and outs. They can pummel us hard as they like. But we will always get back up and fight. That's who we are. Outlaws for life, fellas. Wait until we have John, Mac, Charles, and Sean back riding with us, and I believe, I know, they will all be back.
Well, you didn't get combed, but this hit will hurt him a lot more than any bullet in the head.
Especially when we rob this train, too.
Yeah, I guess we'll see about that.
Oh, indeed we will.
You know, he'll come after us.
Oh, of course he will, just like all the rest. But we're gonna stay a step ahead of them. Make sure we always know where they are before they know where we are. We allowed ourselves to get a step behind in Blackwater. That won't happen again. All right, dig in, fellas. Let's make some ground.
Not very much digging in when we're doing light jogging.
Hey, you see that fella? Wasn't he at the camp with Cone?
Leave him to me.
All right, we're heading back. Just bring him back alive. He could be useful.
Okay, you got it.
Ah!
What the heck? Ah, shit! No! Don't hurt me!
You're coming with me.
Please, please, you don't need to do this.
Salute, you see what you got on you.
Now, I'm just gonna...
I'm no use to you, really.
Come on.
You got me mixed up with someone else.
Did we now?
What's your name, boy?
I don't know.
You don't know your name?
It's Kieran.
Kieran what?
Duffy. Kieran Duffy.
Well, I ain't gonna lie to you. This is a real bad day for you, Kieran Duffy.
Where are you taking me?
Somewhere you ain't gonna like.
Why? What are you gonna do to me?
Some fan you ain't gonna like. So I'd advise you to save your breath for screaming.
No, please! Come on, mister. Please!
Shut it for you.
Just let me go, please. Oh, God, please, no. Oh, take it easy. You're gonna break my ribs.
Are you trying to test me? Is that it? Because I will break every bone in your body.
I'm sorry. Okay?
Not one more goddamn word. Am I clear?
Okay.
That's two bones right there. Here we are, you sack of shit. Let's introduce you to the boys. That's good work,
boy. Come here.
Don't hurt me, please.
Oh, don't worry. They're real nice. Huh.
You found a little shit, did you?
Yep. I got him.
Very good. Welcome to your new home. Hope you're real happy here.
You want me to make him talk?
Oh, no. Now all we'll get is lies. Uncle, Mr. Williamson, tie this maggot up someplace safe. We get him hungry first. I got a saying, my friend. We shoot fellas as need shooting, save fellas as need saving, and feed them as need feeding. We are gonna find out what you need. I can't believe it! An O'Driscoll in my camp!
I ain't an O'Driscoll, mister! I hate that fella!
Oh, whatever you say, son. Well done, Arthur.
I'm just sorry we missed out on Cole.
Oh, there's time enough for that. Now? I gotta figure out if we can hit that train.
Okay.
A few days later.
It's been a bad few weeks, but Dutch. Being Dutch, he is busy making plans, and Dutch being Dutch, those plans involve robbery and dreams. Well, I thought you was reading him his last rites. Now I see you're introducing him to your other passion.
I'll mind you to show me some respect, Mr. Morgan.
Mind away, Reverend. You still here, then?
I owe you.
Yeah, and you'll pay me. But for the moment, just rest.
Arthur, I think it's time for the train.
You want me to come?
Of course I do, but look at you.
I was always ugly, Dutch. It's just a scratch.
Don't lie still, son. Hello, Abigail.
Dutch?
Jackie.
The boy wanted to see you, John.
He'd see me now. What's left of me? What about you?
Guess I was hoping to see a corpse.
Bide your time. You'll see plenty of them.
You're a rotten man, John Marston.
He is an idiot, Abigail. We all know it. Now, railway men. Bill, now you ride ahead and set the charge at the water tower just before the tunnel.
Ain't a problem. Why are we doing this? Weather's breaking. We could leave. I thought we was lying low.
Yeah, come on.
What do you want from me, Hosea?
I just don't want any more folks to die, Dutch.
We're living, Hosea. We're living. Look at me. We're living. Even you. But we need money. Everything we have's in Blackwater. You fancy heading back there?
No. Listen, Dutch, I ain't trying to undermine you. I just want to stick to the plan, which was to lie low, then head back out west. Now, suddenly we're about to rob a train.
What choice have we got?
Leviticus Cornwall's no joke, Dutch.
Who is Leviticus Cornwall?
He's a big railway magnate, sugar dealer, oil man.
Well, how good for him?
Sounds like he has more than enough to share.
Dutch!
Gentlemen, it is time to make something of ourselves. Get your horses ready. We have a train to rob. Everyone ready? All right, let's head out. Yeah. Okay, gentlemen, listen up. All of you, according to the information so kindly provided to us by the O'Driscolls, the train will be coming north from Big Valley. We're gonna pick it off after it crosses the border into the Grizzlies. There's a raised spot there that should give us good vantage. Charles, you'll keep lookout for any outriders. How's that hand, by the way?
I'll be fine.
Good. I'll take the driver and engineer, then run point. Lenny and Javier, you two take the front cars, deal with any guards. Arthur and Micah, you head straight for the back. That's what we're after. Mr. Cornwall's private car.
You and me, Morgan.
Great.
Have you got a problem with that?
Not if you keep your head for once.
You worry about yourself, huh?
Enough! After Bill blows the tracks, we're gonna need to move fast. Is everyone clear on what they're doing?
Yep.
Crystal.
Yes, boss.
Good. Now, come on. Let's ride. We need to get this done fast. Now it's thawing before anyone gets up here after us. Oh, look at you boys. See? This is what I call a crew. Micah Bell, Charles Smith, Arthur Morgan, Javier Escuela, and what about young Lenny here? Always the first man on his horse.
Just happy we're back at him, Dutch.
You sure you're ready for this, kid?
Of course I'm ready.
Just stay calm. Keep your eyes sharp. That goes for all of you. No mistakes. Not again.
So we do this, then we go back to Blackwater to collect.
How many times you gonna ask the same question, Micah?
That's a lot of damn money to leave sitting for too long.
It would be crazy to go back there now. The place will be swarming with Pinkertons.
We go back when I say. We go back, and that's the end of it. The money's safe. You'll just have to trust me. And if the O'Driscolls are right, there'll be a stack of railroad bonds on this train. Good money, once we work out how to cash them. There's the water tower. Hold up here on the ridge. Hold. Is Bill there?
Yeah.
You want to head down, see how he's getting on?
Okay.
Yeah.
How you getting on?
Yeah. I'm okay.
You sure?
Of course.
Can I help a little?
All right.
Go ahead and set up the detonator by those rocks over there.
Okay, sure.
Now just unspool the wire and then attach it to said detonator.
This is good.
All right. That should do it. You head back up to the others. I got it from here.
Plan, all of you, no mistakes.
What's going on?
He says all fine.
We'll soon find out.
Everything okay?
I think so.
Okay, cover your faces. Train should be here any minute now. Gentlemen, it's time. Good luck, all of you. You all know what to do.
Here we go.
Shit! No! What? God!
Oh, you have got to be kidding me!
Where did you find that moron?
Who said it was fine?
It was my fault.
Come on!
You're pathetic. You know that?
I got you, kid.
Hey, down here! Just pull me up!
I've got you. Now stop yelling.
Oh, shit. Shit. Help!
Yeah, you're okay. Now, let's go slow this thing down.
Where's Javier?
He fell. The others will get him.
Hell of a stop.
Look out! Got more coming off the train.
There better be some money at the end of this.
All these bastards must be guarding something.
We need the car at the back, right?
Yep. Keep pushing on.
Shoot him! Take him down! Ho ho! You're done now!
money and go.
We got some fellas holed up in this last car.
Ah, shit.
What are you boys planning on doing in there? Listen to me. We don't want to kill any of you.
Any more of you.
I give you my word, but trust me, we will.
I work for Leviticus Cornwall.
Come on, boys.
We got our orders.
Okay. You asked for it.
We ain't
Five,
opening this door.
4, 3, 2, 1. Seems our friends have gone deaf. Wake them up a little. That's enough.
Mr. Williamson, give Mr. Morgan and Mr. Smith some dynamite. You two boys go blow that door open.
Now, don't matter too much to us, but you boys in there might want to take a step
Seems
back.
Good enough.
Here
now
we go.
Light the fuse.
Unless you got a death wish, I'd step back, fellas.
Get on up there. Search that train.
Look at this place. It's like a palace.
Now I've seen everything. Oh, you two got the safe? I'll search the rest.
Oh, yes. Should be easy as cake.
Letter
just gonna
here.
Stand there, kid. Pour me some brandy, will ya?
I'll put it in the work.
Shut up. Me and Arthur did all the work.
Yeah, kid did good. Didn't see you rushing to jump on that train.
He's keen. I'll give you that. Okay, let's see if we can get this open. Come on. Getting there. There. See? That's how it's done. Shit. Just a pile of papers.
Bonds?
I don't think so. Here. Make yourself useful. At least we all know you can read.
Give me those.
Railroad contracts, invoices, blah, blah, blah. You got anything?
Not really. Sugar imports from the Spanish West Indies. A lot of sugar. Some fancy new boat he's ordered from Europe.
Think I got him.
Nice.
Well, thank God. Come on.
A little salute on the train.
What did you find?
These. Bonds. They worth anything?
Oh, sure. Bearer bonds. I think we can probably sell these pretty easily.
Well done. Now, would you get rid of all of this?
The train?
Yeah, get it out of here.
What about them?
What do you think?
I don't know.
It's up to you. Kill them, leave them here, take them with you on the train. Just make sure they don't send no folk after us.
Okay.
See you back at camp. When you get back, we'll be moving on. The rest of you, let's ride!
Okay, get on the train, quick, all of you. Any bright ideas, I kill all three, so behave. Come on, move!
We won't tell a soul, I swear!
Said quick! If I hear so much as a footstep from this car, you'll end up like all your friends out here.
That's a lot of them. All done. Taken care of.
So, we getting out of this hellhole?
We're gonna try. Weather seems stable.
And we just robbed the Leviticus Cornwall train.
We got money in our pockets. The worst is behind us, gentlemen. So the question is, where now?
I know this country a little. I told you, we should set up camp in Horseshoe Overlook near Valentine. We'll be able to hide out there no problem, as long as we keep our noses clean.
Well then, let's go. Clean noses and everything else. Arthur, you're in that one. Bring Hosea. I know you two like to talk about the good old days and what's gone wrong with old Dutch.
Damn, the music's good.
Get over here!
Yes, boss.
You two ride up ahead, make sure there's no surprises. We've had enough of those.
Me? With the boy?
Just go.
Come on, kid. You can buy me a whiskey.
Let's take a look.
You all right back there?
Does everything look all right?
Well, what's going on?
Ah, I broke the goddamn wheel.
All right, let's get it fixed.
You need help?
I reckon we can handle it. All right, Charles, you and me hold the thing up while you try and put the wheel back on, Arthur.
You still strong enough to hold up a wagon?
Shut up.
I'm just saying.
Don't say less. Pick the wheel up.
See? You ain't so useless after all.
Not quite.
What do you think? If they wanted trouble, we wouldn't have seen them.
Poor bastards. We really screwed them over down here. Come on, let's not push our luck.
What happened?
Well, get in. I'll tell you. Not too far now. Stay on this trail. We'll follow the river, then cut left, inland.
Giddy up.
So? Yes. The Indians in these parts got sold a very raw deal. This is the heartlands we're going to. Good farming and grazing country, they lost it all. Stolen clean away from them it was, every blade of grass. Killed or herded up to the reservations in the middle of nowhere.
And how's that different from anywhere else?
Well, maybe it's not. I just heard some of the army out here was particularly unpleasant about it.
Unpleasant? How do you rob and kill people pleasantly? We don't. In spite of Dutch's talk.
I fear I was perhaps trying to simplify something more complicated for the benefit of our blockheaded driver here.
Hey, don't blame it on me. Never forget, this here's a con man, Charles, born and bred. Just because it sounds fancy don't mean he knows a damn thing about what he's talking about.
Yep.
So, what happened to your tribe?
I don't even know if I have one. At least, not that I can remember. My father was a colored man. He told me he lived with our people for a while. A number of free men did. When we were forced to move from our land, the three of us fled. I was too young to really remember much. My whole life I've been on the run. A couple years later, some soldiers captured my mother. Took her somewhere. We never saw her again. We drifted around. He was a very sad man, and the drink had a mean hold on him. Around 13, I just took off on my own.
That was about the age we found young Arthur here. Maybe a little older. A wilder delinquent you never did see. But he learned fast.
Not as fast as Marston, apparently.
Wait, I don't understand. What's the problem between you two?
Arthur?
It's a long story. Yeah. We still heading the right way?
That depends. Are we still heading west in search of fortune and repose in virgin forests as we plan? No. Are we heading in the correct direction on our desperate escape from the law eastwards down the mountains? Yes, I believe so.
You know this area?
A little. I've been through a couple of times. There's a livestock town not too far from here called Valentine. Cowboys, outlaws, working girls, our kind of place.
Driscoll's?
Probably them too.
Pinkerton's?
Let's hope not.
And this place we're going. Wait, what's it called again?
Horseshoe Overlook.
It's a good place to lie low.
It'll do for now. And how low do you think Dutch is really going to lie? It's just, you know, maybe it's me who's changed, not him, but we kept telling him that ferry job didn't feel right. You and me had a real lead in Blackwater that could have worked out.
Maybe.
It just isn't like Dutch to lose his head like that.
Things go wrong sometimes. People die. It's the way it is. Always has been. Me, you, Dutch. We've all been in this line of work a long time. And we're still here, so I figure we must have got it right a hell of a lot more than we got it wrong. What are you working on there, anyway?
Just some yarrow and ginseng. Good for the health. Better than that stuff you buy in the store. Yeah, you can have all this. I'm at the point where I can do it with my eyes closed.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Yeah.
There you are, brother. Head in there and follow the track for a bit.
Thanks.
Hey, slow up. I'll jump on. Okay, let's go.
Any trouble getting in here, Javier?
Nope. It went well. This is a good spot.
Excellent. I think this will work for us, Arthur. For now, anyway. Here we are, gentlemen. Home sweet home.
so.
Gentlemen, we have survived.
For now.
Now, it is time to prosper.
Arthur and I were about to prosper in Blackwater. We were onto something big. Then Micah got you all excited about that ferry, and here we are.
We have all made mistakes over the years, Hosea. Every last one of us. But I kept us together. Kept us alive. Kept the nooses off our neck.
I guess I'm just worried. I ain't got that long, Dutch. I want folks safe before I go.
Me too.
And now we are stuck. East of the Grizzlies and out of money. And a long way from our dream of virgin land in the west.
I know, my brother. But we are safe. We make a bit of money here. Then we move again. Head out around them. Be west of Uncle Sam. In a few months, buy some land.
I hope so.
Would you just look around you? This world has its consolations.
Gentlemen, I'm going to head into the local town and, see if I can strike up a little business.
Of course, Herr Strauss. I prefer robbing banks to usury. Seems more dignified somehow. Now, everyone, put your tools down for a moment. Come on, gather around. Quickly now. I know that things have been tough, but we are safe now, and we are far too poor. So it is time for everyone to get to work.
Get to work, but stay out of trouble. Remember, we are itinerant workers.
Laid off when they shut down our factory to the north. Now get out there and see what you can find. Uncle, Reverend Swanson, no more passengers. It is time for everyone to earn their keep.
There is a town a little way down the track named Valentine. Livestock town, all mud and morons, if I remember right. That seems a decent place to start.
And, we need food. Real food. That means every day. One of you.
And remember, whatever it is that you find, the camp gets its slice. Now be sensible out there.
Now the girls have your tent ready, Mr. Morgan. Come with me. You two will be ready shortly. We put you over here.
I'm sure everything will be fine, Miss Grimshaw.
It should be. Most of your stuff from Blackwater got saved.
Everything apart from my money.
Oh, don't remind me.
Well, we can always make more money.
We're gonna have to. Miss Jackson, I've seen shit with more common sense than you. Do it properly.
Chapter 2. Horseshoe Overlook. A couple of weeks later, back in the mud.
Got off the mountain, rode east into some pretty enough country called the Heartlands. Ain't been this far east in many a year. Dutch seems a little better. His eyes are sparkling once more, and I can see he's thinking a little clearer. I think we all feel a little happier, in spite of Blackwater and that whole mess.
Arthur?
Jose?
Thank you.
Quite a day.
Let's hope so.
There's a bunch of the boys already in Valentine. Bill, Charles, and Javier. And Swanson found something down at the train station by the lake, apparently. And Strauss came back with that creepy little smile on his face. I'm sure there's a whole list of unfortunates he's forced money upon.
Thank you. And you?
I'm gonna read a book.
Cattleman revolver, double action revolver, sawed off, carbine repeater. Okay. something around the back.
Oh, Arthur, my boy. My dear boy.
What's going on?
Nothing. Nothing at all. For the first time in weeks, nothing. We're free. We're free to plan our own future once more.
I hope so, Dutch.
You kept the faith, Arthur. You always kept it.
And I ain't losing it now.
Okay, so this is ammo provisions. Food provisions, health provisions.
Morning, Arthur.
What do you think of this place, Susan?
An improvement on the last, that's for sure.
Well, that ain't too hard.
How are you, Jack? Hear you was sick?
A little bit, but Uncle Hosea gave me some medicine.
Okay, good. Well, I should get back to it.
Uh-huh.
How much money I got? $52. Let me actually head.
You overcook this now, Pearson. Thank you. Thank you, Arthur.
All right, let's head into town, see what we can buy.
Thank you.
Actually, I do want to switch those around. I want the bow. I want that to be the rifle.
Hunt continues for Cornwall train robbers.
That'd be the bow.
Want to buy paper?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Pick a good one there. Make sure you come back tomorrow. Get your news here, Valentine.
Yeah. Well, new marksman in town. Welcome.
Well, I use this space as a blacksmith, too, so let me know if you need me to grab something for you from the catalog.
Let's have a look.
It's locked. Snag a volcano.
Carry it with pride. We can do a lot with this. New trigger, brand new bolt. Your pick. Fine piece. How about you get some new sights for this, huh? It's yours now.
I don't feel like doing all
I'd like to give this a personal touch with some engraving.
We'll use the volcano pistol probably for now. And I'm gonna grab a varmint rifle, because...
You love it.
They are fantastic for headshots.
You know what? I bet I can make this piece work a lot better for you. Bolts, triggers... parts back here.
I ain't got enough money. Get a scope on it as well. Springfield probably wouldn't be bad either. Snag a free pump action.
Yep, this is the one.
Alright. Thanks, bookkeep.
I'm looking forward to testing this out. Thank you for your help. Out of the way!
Yeah, for now, I'll rock the volcano pistol.
Paper. See ya. Get your papers right here.
And I guess I'll holster it. Feed it a little something. Then we're gonna brush them. I need a brush, apparently.
Morning. Morning, mister.
Here.
You got a problem?
Javier.
Howdy.
Well,
but I think, honestly, that should probably be it for this episode. Hey. So, next episode, we'll see what's going on in the saloon. But until then. This is Solo Fett, signing off.